I like stunning, I like shining, I like $1 million deals. Where's my pen? Bitch, I'm signing. I like those Balenciagas, the ones that look like socks. I like going to the Tula, I put rocks all in my watch. I like texts from my exes when they want a second chance. I like proving niggas wrong, I do what they say I can't. They call me Cardi, Cardi, banging body, spicy mommy, hot tamale, hotter than a Somali.
Hello, my name is Abby, I'm 15 years old and I'm going to talk about fashion. Is it a woman thing or doesn't consider as all? Also, quality determines some clothing choices and then clothes can show someone's emotions, ambitions, type of employment, spending habits. So, while clothes are revealing, what messages are they sending and how can you use your wardrobe to change how others perceive you and even how you think about yourself? There's no guide to follow, never look miserable. The worst thing you can do is to try to look like someone else but yourself and don't pay attention to where you are and how old are you, what your body does or the particular situation you are in. What your clothes say to you? As I said before, your clothes can talk to you. Let's talk about an experiment conducted by the Northwestern University. They examined the concept known as the cloth condition. In simple words, this describes the influence your clothes have on your psychology, how they actually make you feel. The researchers gave all the participants a white lab coat. The half of the participants were said that this was a doctor's coat, and the other half that it was a major smock. All participants performed the same task, but those wearing the doctor's coat were more careful and attentive. Their actions were influenced by their clothing. When you dress in a certain way, it helps shift your internal self, explains Dr. Baumgartner. Even actors say putting on costume facilitates expression of character. That's just as true for everyday life. This experiment gives scientific proof to the idea that you should dress not how you feel, but how you want to feel. I'm sure lots of you can identify with this. I found this table from Dr. Baumgartner books, You Are What You Wear, where I presented the most common wardrobe and perception problems. Let me focus on just some of them. Some people cannot really accept that they are getting older, and this is obvious to their dressing style. They identify with the saying that you are as old as you feel, but this is not the case with the looks. The same goes with people my age who chose inappropriate clothes for teenagers because they rush to get older. There are also these workaholic people who always wear work clothes. However, there are two viewpoints to this matter. On the one hand, it is so that these people value themselves primarily through their work. On the other, very successful business people think otherwise. Mark Zuckerberg or Steve Jobs are very common figures. You must have noticed that they wear the same kind of clothes, but there's an explanation over on the rest of workaholics. They chose show because of simplicity, they chose style and sophistication over trend. Most successful people find a look that is comfortable, functional, and flattering for them. Once they find their look, they stick to it. In some cases, the look becomes their signature. Take a look at this picture, for example. Many people are obsessed with brands and very expensive garments. According to psychology, this attitude reveals you need to be treated well by others just because you look healthy. And this trend brings to my mind the so-called Instagram influencers. Take a look at an Instagram influencer account. Let's start with the definition. What is an influencer? In the dictionary, it is defined as a person with the ability to influence potential buyers of a product or service by promoting or recommending their items on social media. This kind of Instagram user is extremely prevailing on us, more and more people are trying to make an income from this business and they are sponsored by big companies to promote their products. For some, this is actually their only source of income. The most dreadful thing is that the 70% of the teenagers are extremely affected by them and much more convinced to compare to another celebrity, an actor or something. And all the more they tend to mediate their lives and convince they're fashionable since the influencer is wearing it. All the brands are trying to take advantage of the influencer's impact on the teens, as the latter spend 70% of their time on their smartphone on social media purely for entertainment. There's a grave problem here. Teenagers, in the years of innocence and discovering themselves and their goals in life, spend the majority of their time looking into the picture perfect lives of such individuals. Following the influencer's account on a bit of their led to a life of comparison. The teens are easily impressed by the glamorous and fashionable content and might not even realize it, considering appropriate or the accepted from a lifestyle. The life they present makes the youth feel not good enough or not content with themselves, which leads to dreadful results due to the overuse of social media. Teens addicted to social media are found to be more susceptible to grave issues, such as addicted to social media are found to be more susceptible to grave issues such as depression and others such as body dysmorphia and the complete lack of communication skills due to the cut off from the real world. Girls seem to get more affected and more easily manipulated by social media. For example, a survey conducted by the Guardian observes the ever-increasing dissatisfaction the young girls harbor within them in regards to their body. They continue to face the harsher side effects of cyberbullying and online harassment on their own without even confiding to their parents or friends. 51% of girls of the age of 14 and 16 tend to be unhappy with their appearance and want to look like someone else. They are also found to be deeply affected and go in self-doubt about their looks, even they see celebrities who they think of to be perfect. Following fashion is one thing, but following influencer is something extremely risky. We teenagers should think twice before trying to imitate someone's style. We are unique and our personality bears no resemblance to an influencer trying to manipulate young people in order for him to become richer. Love yourself as it is. Thank you.
I like stunning, I like shining, I like million dollar deals. Where's my pen? Bitch, I'm signing. I like those Balenciagas, the ones that look like socks. I like going to the Tula, I put rocks all in my watch. I like texts from my exes when they wanna